Greetings, this is Nai Tai with NNV News. Today I have the honor of interviewing Brother Darren X, who is a member of the Nation of Islam, an artist, and an entrepreneur. So as soon as he goes ahead and joins, we're going to start our interview. Oh, there he is. That was fast. Okay, I'm going to record. And you all can go ahead and follow us on here, NNV News, and then check out our website, nnvnews.com. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, ma'am.
How are you doing today, brother?
I'm doing well. Is the camera up? Oh, there it is. Okay. Cool. You got it.
There you go. All right. Well, we could just go ahead and start then. Do you mind introducing yourself? Let us know what you do, who you are.
Okay. First and foremost, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God, no God but Allah. I bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. Assalamu alaikum, family. My name is Brother Darren X. I am an artist, entrepreneur, first and foremost, though, student of the Honorable Brother Minister Louis Farrakhan, and a member of the Nation of Islam, FOI. And everything that I do, everything I desire to do, is centered around the mission of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, bar none. Like, that's it. Anybody got smoke with that, then no. That's how we coming.
Yes, sir. Praise be to Allah. That's beautiful. That's just a beautiful mission statement right there in itself. So I've only been able to see your Instagram. Do you have any other type of social medias that you post on?
I do have a Twitter. Now, okay, so what happened was I used to have a larger following prior to me coming into the nation, and I ran into a bit of an identity crisis. As you know, the teachings, I wasn't born in a nation. So when I came into the teachings, the weight of it all, you know, all my considerations, my life path, the trajectory of my life just shifted. So right. I started to reassess social relationships, who I was, what I meant. So I deleted my other social media page, my other Instagram page. I got rid of my other Twitter page. And I started over from scratch. So It's B Darren X, which is also recent because just maybe like 3 weeks ago, it was still Free Kid Beans, the artist name that mm-hmm. I had originally went under. But, you know, I'm in a period where it's like I'm giving my all to Allah. So I don't want anything associated with who I used to be. And a God said, behold, I make all things new.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, I do know a lot of people who are not born in the nation or people who are interested in the nation or kind of just in the nation now who have had their own different journeys, because it's definitely a journey, something you got to go through, something you have to experience. And do you share your journey a lot often with others? Because I'm sure that there is something that other people could learn from you just hearing your experiences rather than having to go through it themselves.
Yes, ma'am. Anyone who is genuinely, and I use that adjective like with some force behind it, genuinely interested in knowing like what I've been through and how I've gotten to this point, I'm open to it. Those who ask questions from a wicked spirit, I'll be patient up until a point, because you're not, when I can perceive that you're not asking these questions to really learn something, but you're looking right. towards something, judgment, criticism. Absolutely not. But from my assessment, I have been able to help persons to get a better understanding of the Nation of Islam, the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because of my unique journey up until this point. Studying Mother Tynetta, probably one of the biggest reasons that I'm still in the Nation of Islam. One of her articles in the final call, she was discussing about, you know, you have to study your own life. Because there you see more intimately how Allah has been over your life up until you get into the Nation of Islam as preparation for your work. So I came out of the church, grew up Church of God in Christ, YPWW, choir rehearsal, choir director, all of that. I was all involved. Got away from it because questions were Christianity. Speed up time. I had this experience where I needed to know if God was real or not. God showed me he was real, so it was no question on that. Christianity, I started to doubt it because I couldn't make the connection between Jesus and that whole piece. Then I went into the conscious community, quote unquote, conscious community, you know, spirituality, the meditation, the yoga, the Buddhism, playing with all of these different ideas, sacred geometry. And then I dismissed Islam completely because I read like maybe a few ayats and I saw Moses' name and Abraham, and I'm like, oh, this is the same as the Bible. So I just skipped over it. And then so fast forward, you know, in 2016, November 12, 2016, I heard Minister Nuri Muhammad in Rockford. From that day to the 13th, that Sunday, I went that Sunday to hear the Sunday lecture. Monday, I was in FOI processing class, and I remained just constantly going, learning until December 10th, 2017. And so what I've been able to offer is, for one, people have this misconception that you hear the minister or you hear the teachings and you become quote unquote brainwashed, or you move by the emotion. Oh, it's just a phase or whatever, because it's a certain kind of magnetism that comes to it. Not so for myself. I mean, I was enamored with the Honorable Brother Minister Louis Farrakhan, completely enamored, to the point where it started to concern me, because I've never felt love for another man like I did. Matter of fact, nor anybody else. And since I had been disappointed, I wanted to run from it. So I kind of just distanced myself a little bit emotionally from it, because it's just something that I wasn't comfortable with. But I couldn't deny what I was hearing and what I was reading of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And it would be verified if I would just be patient. So I spent a year, a little over a year and a month, processing, studying, making sure that what I was getting into was what it was. So for me, I tell people who coming into the nation, it's like, man, bro, if you study, if you really put your mind and your heart on this, to and not coming in to try to, even if you're coming in to disprove it, you come in honestly to disprove it, meaning that when you find that it's true, you accept it, you will make it, and you will have a firm foundation. So that's my story. And so people who come out of the church, people who come out of the spiritual community, I'm able to offer dialogue and then tie the teachings into it and show them that the root is with the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for sharing that story with us. I'm sure there's a lot more that you did leave out, but thank you for just sharing that small part with us. I think it's very important to take the time to listen to other people's stories and how they got to where you got, because I can relate to some of that. I can, and I'm sure a lot of other people, some of our viewers even maybe can relate to that. So how do you reflect what you've learned in the Nation of Islam through the content that you make and post on social medias?
Right now, my content is it's in a transition, because I'm finding a flow of what it is, you know, like how to express it. Because before, it could have just been anything. Now, recently, I'll share this because, I mean, it happened in the public, so I can share it in the public. I had a video of me dancing, and I dance as well. But where I was dancing, it just wasn't reflective of the brand, right, of being an FOI. And it was, I had a discussion with the captain, with one of the officers and some of the brothers. And so out of love, right, it was shown that you have to be able, like, because I'm here and this organization is not mine, we belong to Master Farid Muhammad. So in everything we do, we have to properly represent Master Farid Muhammad, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and the minister. We got to keep our general orders in effect. We have to keep in line our structure and our culture, because this is something new and it can't be tainted, tampered with, mixed in any way, shape, or form. So I made a mistake, but in that, I saw the opportunity to be able to, you know, do what I love to do, but just in a different way. So my content, I'm just finding the spirit is there, but the means to rightly like put it out there so that it's in complete harmony. Even if it challenges some of the norms, that's fine, as long as it's in harmony with the teachings and what it is we have to establish as registered believers in the nation.
Yes, sir. I appreciate the fact that you were humble enough to admit what you had done. Yes, sir, that's beautiful. And I heard you mention that you're an entrepreneur, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So what type of products do you make and how can we support you?
Okay. So right now I deal with cheesecakes mostly. I've been in a transition again, as far as my moving situation. So I haven't been able to bake. I'm very particular about my products, my ingredients. So if I don't have certain things, I don't put it to the people. But my cheesecake is called Late Effantastic Cheesecake. Everything is homemade. The sugar I use is the Demerara sugar that we get from the farm. The flour I use is the flour we get from the farm. And just wholesome ingredients. I do my best to try to get wholesome ingredients. I'm also dealing with a Beta clothing line. I'm dealing with a lifestyle brand. And the lifestyle brand is Borpa Tulip, BORPATULIP, meaning balance, oneness, relentless patience, or resurrected power, awareness, truth, unconditional love, and infinite peace. So these things have been germinating for a while in the womb of my mind. And again, it's just getting it out in the right way. I've already invested in the first line of the first product line, which is called Perfect Obedience. And on some of my videos, so I'll have, in time, you'll see the shirts, you'll see, jogging pants and things like that, just different apparel. The cheesecake, as I continue, just get my situation straight so I can get everything that I need, I'll be putting those out again maybe in another week or two. And then as well as my music, that's another product. It seems like I'm all over the place, but it's all coming together.
Yes, yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Do you have any social medias for?
Yeah, so my SoundCloud, if you go to my SoundCloud is still Free Kid Beans. So that's FreeKidD, and then it's a space BEANS. So that'll be what it is until I start another SoundCloud and, get my stuff on Tidal situated. And on Tidal, iTunes, Spotify, you'll find Free Kid Beans that's still up. So, but that music that's up is still harmonious with the teachings. It came out of that transition space.
Yes, sir. Okay, so you make cheesecakes. Wow, praise be to Allah. I can say that I don't know many, if any, other Black men that bake cheesecakes.
So best cheesecakes in the world, too. FYI. I'm not lying. Like, you have it, you try it, it's life-changing. And some of the brothers at the mosque in Chicago have had it. Sister Carmella with mm-hmm. the food spot, she's tasted it, so she can bear witness that it's golden.
Wow, I'll have to try one day. Why would you recommend brothers to know how to bake or cook?
Well, okay. So in all honesty, this crazy notion that women are just supposed to like iron clothes and cook and just wait on us hand and foot is ridiculous, because like we're coming into a period where we need the second self of God's perspective to be able to recalibrate this world and then to usher in that whole new thing. Secondly, just I'm single, right? But obviously, I wasn't born in a nation, so that whole, like, I have a history prior to. One of the things that I picked up from that history is that women love men who can cook. So if, just imagine your wife comes home, or maybe you just surprise her, and it's a meal on the table. It's something sweet, a cookie or whatever the case may be, a cheesecake. Like, she appreciates it. And then, she's comforted in knowing that, okay, he can maintain like, and without me or protect me, that's just another level of protection, provision, and maintenance, because you know how to cook. So, and then it's also therapeutic. It's a way you can relieve your stress. It's a way you can tap into your feminine nature. And we need to know both. I mean, you can be super Mr. Macho Man all you want to, but that's not going to cut it, brother, not in today. We need to be more balanced. And as you can see, like, as the Honorable Brother Minister teaches us how the prophets are fashioned as women in relationship to Allah. Well, it should be the same way. You know, we are fashioned as women to the mission and the work of the Nation of Islam. The men are, and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. So we got to know that. And then that's a way to practice it so that it finds manifestation in other areas of our lives.
Yes, sir. And I heard you mention that cooking is a way to kind of like relieve stress or bring your energy up, which made me think of When you're cooking, however you're feeling, like your emotions, you actually put your emotions into whatever you're creating, you're cooking or baking. And I remember this one time, I'm sorry, this may be a little a little off topic, but I remember this one time there was a sister who baked something for us, and she was just really going through it at the moment. And you could taste that in the food. Like it was like you could taste her emotion and her sadness in it. So it is very important to keep a high spirit when creating or making dishes, food, baking. That just came to me at the moment. But why do you think it's important to have your own business and do for self, especially as a Black individual?
It's okay. So it does have value, but I don't want to be of those who are kind of like pushing this message that you have to be a business owner per se, because it's really not for everyone. But the value in it for us is that it establishes, for me, is going to help me to be financially free. I personally don't care about too much other than a work and a mission. That might seem like fanatical. People might say, well, you still new in it or whatever the case may be. I don't think so. I've been registered since 2017. And every day, the more I don't do of the work, I get more and more frustrated with myself. And so having a business allows me, one, to come in a way of Master Far Muhammad, because as I get a chance to make contact with people, you ask the questions like, okay, well, what do you do outside of the cheesecake? It just becomes a way to build social relationships. And in which case, now we can talk about the work. We can talk about God coming in person in whatever degree or level that person is on, but I'm able to make that kind of contact. And it frees me up to be able to, you know, do more. Who knows? Like, we may need to go to this city, that city. We may need to, you know, support a mission or, you know, a drive or whatever the case may be. And so we're not thwarted collectively because, you know, something that the business owners are doing. We're out in a community. We're, you know, creating an economy, building all. It's just all of these social together. So when you have, you're in control of your life, your time more, when you can get it to a system where you're free to do what Allah has put in you to do with more fervor, because you're not thinking about what you owe. And then you're touching lives on top of that. So it's a lot. I mean, that's not a question that can be answered in such a short statement. I just gave as much as I possibly could in considering the time and everything.
Yes, sir, absolutely. And why do you think it's important that we spend our money with our own in our communities first, rather than going out and spending it in larger corporations that are white owned?
Because, well, one, because they could give a damn about us, really, when it comes down to it. If it's not affecting their bottom, if, like, Colin Kaepernick, you know, the I Can't Breathe, Black Lives Matter, you see all of these companies that have supported it in a very surface way, but you're not getting to the root of the problem. So now I have to question why you're doing it to begin with. And then you realize, like, okay, well, Black people, this is what they talk about in these offices. If Black people stop supporting us, we're done.
Right.
You know that, right? So I'm gonna give my money as best as I can to people who I know who look like me. Like, when Foodies was closed, for the time it was closed, hated going elsewhere to get food. I kid you not. So now that it's back open again, it's like, man, let me shop with Sister Carmella. Sister Hania is another sister in Chicago that cooks. Mm-hmm. A few weeks ago, at my father's repast, like, I wanted to get some food from, you know, if I'm gonna bring some food, it's like, I'm gonna support one of the sisters or one of the brothers in the nation. And there was another sister, her name is escaping me right now, and I hate it because I would really love to pup her, but she made a red velvet cake.
And Sister Marcia?
Sister Marcia, yes. Yes, Sister Marcia. Cakes are on point. So that's where I want to spend my bread. That's where I want to give my energy to. I don't really care how much it costs. If I don't have it, then I just don't have it. But if I have it, I'm going to shop with you because it feels better. And it's not even about money at that point. It's just about I know I'm feeding the reality of the establishment of the kingdom of God on a higher level. But it's showing love to my sister, showing love to my brother.
Absolutely, yes, sir. And at a time like now, that's such an important mindset to have, that a lot of us, not only our youth, don't have. So praise be to Allah that you're able to think like this. Praise be to Allah. What is an important aspect of your life that you practice every day?
Seriously? Okay, so I got to be honest, right? Because 100% is 100%. And if it's not 100%, it's not 100%. So I can't say that I make my prayers every day 100%. But I can say that prayer is always on my mind. And I rarely go to sleep without having made up all of my prayers or the prayer that I missed. So that's one of the biggest things to me. It's to the point now where if I, like, it's on my mind. I was blessed to do a detail the other day, and due to the nature of the detail, I wasn't able to make prayer. But the whole time, like, I gotta make a lot. So I got home, and I had a call, and after that call, I was like, man, I need to make up all of my prayers. Went in and I did it. But it's just a certain kind of, the Holy Quran says that Allah would not care for you were it not for your prayers. It also says Allah is our patron. Their help comes from Allah. Allah is the source of peace. These are the things I need in my life. I need peace. I need help in everything that I do. So if I'm not making my prayers, then I can't even confidently call on Allah, knowing like, okay, so you're not
right.
Come talk to me. Do it. I just need 8 minutes, 8 to 10 minutes of your time. Just bow down, submit, sajda, come up out of that thing, and you can get back to business. I can't get that. And you breathing, your heart beating. So prayer is a big thing. And more recently, thanks to a conversation I had with Sister Carmela, she told me to pick one of the principles of Islam and focus on those. And so what I've decided to settle on is fasting. Because prayer is just automatic. I know I'm going to do that with the help of Allah. Right. But fasting, I want fasting for me to be a real life lifestyle. So my goal is that one meal every 3 days. And then I recently reviewed How to Eat to Live. And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said, you know, the beyond that is the one meal every 5 days. And then you can just get to the such discipline where you eat when, you know, you hungry. Right. So that might be some time, but I'm certainly aiming for that one meal every 3 days by the end of 2021.
Yes, sir. I'm striving. I'm not sure when I'll get to every 3 days, but every other day. That's what I'm working towards right now. Yes, sir. What do you love about the Nation of Islam? What made you fall in love with the nation?
My first Savior's Day was 2017. I had never experienced anything like a Savior's Day because it's a spirit that comes along with it.
Right.
I believe I'm a spiritual brother. I walked in, I felt it. The brothers in the uniforms, the sisters in the white garments, the assalamu alaikum, assalam. You know, and we were still doing a cheek to cheek back then. So we could still, you know, make that contact. Now, of course, COVID, and nobody wants to deal with that monster. So, you know, we don't do so. But the love that I experienced at Savior's Day 2017, man, is what I saw, the organization as far as the workshops and, you know, the vending section where, you know, different persons were there, different business owners with their products. I was like, oh, man, this is excellent. The security, even as like stuff like that, I love everything about the nation. Even the areas where we need improvement, it's an opportunity to exercise our godhood and make contact with Allah. So it's about the attitude. So I love everything about the nation, but mainly the culture of godhood. Dr. Wesley says he uses Black God Protocol, like that's who we are. It's completely different from any other organization, body on the planet. Like we are being fashioned to be gods. And, you know, I don't I don't care who takes that however way they take it, because one, it's in the scripture, we can verify it that way, and we had a whole living God show up in 1930 and just prove he was God by taking the honor of Elijah Muhammad and say, well, I'll take the least of you and deal with him, and you can't. So looking at the honor of Elijah Muhammad, he traveled around the world. The Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan traveled around the world. Some of the ministers, student ministers, traveling around the world, making connections for, you know, the establishment of God's kingdom. I say that over and over again, but as rulers, not coming in subjugation to any and nobody else. It's like, so we represent God. As for the Master Farah Muhammad, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, members of the Nation of Islam, everybody else until you come see this.
Absolutely. Yes, sir. And
compassion.
No. Yes, sir. That reminds me of a saying that Brother Yahya always says. He says, your attitude determines your altitude. And it's so real. It is so very real. Now, before we go, is there any one last piece of advice you'd like to leave the viewers with? Or if you have more than one, go ahead. Any advice you'd like to leave the viewers with today?
Man, first, accept your own and be yourself is not something you do overnight. Like, once you hear it, you have to learn it. And you don't know yourself until you get until you grow an intimate relationship with Allah. I heard the teachings November 12th, 2016 from Minister Nuri. It's the first time I got like a full exegesis, if you will, or a snippet of the teachings, like in one setting, where this was the central focus, the 13th, and then up until this point. The ghost of the mystery God over the last year has started to fade away, even with knowing and having a conception that Master Farah Muhammad is the supreme being. Like, this was like in my mind, I'm studying it, I'm saying it, point number 12, right? That's cool. But there's aspects of yourself you don't know until you start to deepen your study, until you start to build and, you know, do the fast and do the charity, do the work, do more work. And then after you do that, do more work, where the sludge can start to come off. You still have to make mistakes that Allah will permit you to make. And it depends on what you do with it. Now, are you going to, once it's exposed to view and the losses are manifest from the errors that you've made, are you going to continue down that path, or are you going to allow the light of Islam to light the path to say, okay, this is wrong, I can't do this any longer, and keep going? Right. 3 years in, I've made some mistakes. Like, I don't appreciate, you know, so I look at myself now like, bro, you could have done this better, but I don't harp on it. I keep it as a blessed reminder, like, never to go back to it again, because it makes you feel low. You get these teachings and you know the power that's in it, because, man, if I showed you a picture of myself a few years ago, I have a picture of me at 19 compared to a picture maybe when I, like, around the time I first heard the teachings, completely different look. And then I tell people today, like, my age, and they shocked. And I'm like, man, that's only because of these teachings. I can't run away from that, man. So the good in it, allow the good to nurture you, to feed you. And but Islam is also going to pull the negative up out of you. And so when that happens, look at it and then move. And then you can accept your own and be yourself. But again, remember that is a process that you have to go through over and over again. And submit to the process. Like, you will not, there's no way you're going to be perfect in this. No way. I just don't believe it. I haven't seen it. The minister said he's not perfect. And we can't see none of his imperfections. You know what I'm saying? So if that's the case, we on this level who are rising up to that level, working to closing the gap, then just, man, be patient, take your time, just be honest with yourself, and you'll get there day by day. And don't concern yourself with what other people got going on. Like, look at them for encouragement, inspiration, righteous pressure. Deal with jealousy and envy that you have in your heart. Don't tell me, and maybe some of us don't have it, but a lot of us do have it. Deal with these things, man, because they will hinder you. You won't be able to hear Allah when he's talking to you if, you know, you got all of these spiritual diseases that you have the means and the methodology and the technology to work on, and you're not putting it to use. Right. And Allah is always speaking. He always showing you. He always pointing you in one direction or another. So,
always.
And I'm saying this, still having to sharpen up myself. But the reality is, man, it's a process. Enjoy the process, man. And like, man, really deal with you. Self-improvement is the basis for community development. It's all about self. You build that personal, direct relationship with Allah, and nothing else matters after that. The minister is not successful because we're supporting him. It would be crazy for us to think so. When the Holy Quran tells us that the good we do is for our own soul, we recognize the good in the Honorable Brother Minister was Farrakhan, the work of the Nation of Islam. So when we put forth our tithes, we put forth our time and our efforts, then according to the Holy Quran, which a book there is no doubt in it, you talking about that's something that's benefiting your soul and your progress and your relationship. He's doing his work and he's been doing his work. Right. But he's doing that work because he has this connection with Allah and the Honorable Elijah Muhammad that he cannot shake. And his obligation and his duty is to them. So that's why it's working and that's why it's riding. It's a personal relationship. And we're seeing manifest evidence of what happens when we as a people have a direct and a personal relationship with Allah. Then the reality around us starts to change. Yes, so that's sir. What we have to do. That's it.
Absolutely. Yes, sir. Now, do you have any books that you recommend our viewers read?
What? First and foremost, first and foremost, the Holy Quran. Like, we can't shake that. And I have a few of them. But you definitely wanna get the Holy Quran. That's the best book you can read. I haven't found any book better because that's the book I've read more than any other book. Message to the Black Man, of course. By the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Here is a book from it's a brother by Alan X. It says The Mathematical Theology and the Phases of God. For those of us who are we're nerds with the teachings, supreme wisdom. We love it because it just does something to our psyche. There's another piece, man, from Dr. Wesley. Here we go. The Book of God. The Book of God. This is from Brother Dr. Wesley Muhammad. So those of us, if you have a difficulty understanding the reality of God, this will clear it all up for you. Just take your mind out of the world of spookism or just the ghost of the nebulous cloud. That this God is just everything and the it's and all, and yeah, just take your mind out of that. Read that one. You will be solid. There's another. Oh, okay. So I just finished this one. This is from Brother Saad Muhammad, Jonah. I recommend you read all of his series. Now, I've only read this one, but I started Moses. I didn't finish it. I let somebody borrow it. But I was able to start and finish Jonah within 3 days or so. And What I'll say about that and his series is what it would do is because he comes from a perspective of not necessarily trying to prove, but how he ties in and makes the connections with the scripture. So you're able to see the Honorable Brother Minister Louis Farrakhan, the work of the Nation of Islam, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and Master Far Muhammad in these series from a scriptural perspective. And it's really mostly biblical. So with that, like it strengthens you. But for those who are, you know, maybe still on the fence, and we understand that because, I mean, you didn't know about this. Like, God coming in the form of a man, 1930, that's an instant paradigm shift. So it will take some time, but the resources and the material are here to grow up into that understanding so you're able to hold fast to point number 12. The last book, I said this, not for those, you know, who think I'm biased with the teachings and everything. I am, but whatever. Here's it's a book called The Master Key. This is by Lawrence W.D. Lawrence. Now, it was published in 1914, and we know that there's no such thing as a coincidence. The mm-hmm. devil's civilization ended. It's expired in 1914. And then this whole W. Day Lawrence, I don't know if this was, you know, Master Far Muhammad traveled all over the earth. But the book, when I was reading it, I'm at the part where it starts the exercises. So it helps you deal with focus, concentration, and attention. And we know these are the things that and copying as well. These are the things we exercise when we wrote our letters. So with this, it helps you to strengthen these mental faculties. It teaches you about mental laws. And it's a section in here that deals with having an example. And when I read that, knowing that that was the master key, thinking back on the lecture that Jesus is the key, knowing who the physical manifestation of Jesus is in this day and time, scripturally and everything else, works and all, the Honorable Brother Minister Louis Farrakhan, it that kind of helped me to see a methodology or a practice of how you can get up to that point and in a scientific way. And again, I have a lot going on, like we all do. So I have it. I've started it, and I'm in a process of learning more from it.
Yes, sir.
But give it time.
Yes, sir. And where can we purchase these books from?
You can go to NOI.org to purchase Message to the Black Man. I got the book, The Mathematical Theology and the Physics of God. You may have to, this may be on Amazon, but I purchased this at my first Savior's Day.
Okay.
And so this is like an heirloom. Jonah, I don't know if Brother Saad has a website, but no, I believe these are also on Amazon. So you can find these on Amazon. You can definitely get this one on Amazon as well. So, yes, ma'am.
All right. Yes, sir. Wow, this has been a wonderful interview. I feel as though I've learned a lot from you, even though I've grown up in the teachings.
Voila.
Yes, sir. You seem like a well-educated brother.
Praise be to Allah.
Is there any one last thing that you'd like to leave the viewers with?
Man, seek refuge in Allah. That's the only person you need. And if you got him, nothing is impossible to overcome.
Absolutely. All right. Well, do you mind setting your Instagram real fast so that the viewers can follow you?
Yes, Instagram is B_Darren, DarrenX. Once again, B_DarrenX. Get a follow, or, you know, you just come by and visit and watch the videos or whatever the case. But, you know, show some love.
Yes, sir. And it's B_DarrenX. Yep.
B_DarrenX. Yes, ma'am.
Praise be to Allah. Thank you so very much for volunteering your time to sit down for this interview today. We really appreciate it. Thank you for making this possible.
Darren. Darren.
Yes, sir.
So what do Black people do with them eyes on our names?
All right. Well, thank you all so very much for tuning into NNV News. Please follow us on here, NNV News, and check out our website, nnvnews.com. And again, his Instagram is B_DarrenX.
Yep, there it is. He got it.
Okay. All right. Well, peace. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam, ma'am.
Have a wonderful day.
You as well.